Wall Street Memes Casino.
I'm fine.
And Sportsbook.
Let's meet our main event fighters first. With the record of 43 victories, 34 wins by knockout, no defeats, he is the former 154-pound world champion, the undefeated all-action fighter from Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico, Jaime Munguia. All right, now it is time to meet the king of boxing with a record of 60 victories, with 39 of those coming by knockout, two defeats and two draws. He is a four-division world champion, and he is the current undisputed super middleweight world champion, El Orgulloso Guerrero de Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico, Saúl Canelo Álvarez. All right, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us here. Alongside both of these men, first with Team Munguia, we have the chairman and CEO of Golden Boy Boxing with Oscar De La Hoya, the CEO of Zanford Boxing Promotions, Fernando Beltran, Hall of Fame trainer Freddie Roach. And then for Team Canelo, we have Luis De Cubas Jr., alongside trainers Jose Chepo Reynoso, and manager and trainer Eddie Reynoso, as well as Canelo Alvarez. So we are set to go. This fight week will be a 12-round main event this Saturday, May 4th, from the T-Mobile Arena. It is a PBC pay-per-view event on Prime Video. Here from boxing legend, as well as chairman and CEO of Golden Boy Promotions, please welcome Oscar De La Hoya.
Thank you very much. Please sit down. Thank you very much for being here, for what I truly believe will be the changing of the guard of Mexican boxing from Canelo Alvarez to Jaime Munguia. My sole purpose in this promotion is to support Jaime, an undefeated, incredible talent who deserves a stage and spotlight at this point of his career. However, I would be remiss if I didn't respond to the man I used to promote. He seems to have trouble remembering who helped him become a true global star. To be clear, I have nothing but respect for Canelo Alvarez as a fighter. His record and abilities speak for themselves. But he has spent much of the last 2 months insulting me rather than promoting this fight. So I'll make it a little bit easier for him. Yes, I have faced a lot of challenges in my life. Yes, I've been to rehab several times. Yes, there were some really low points in my life. And yes, there were times that work was not my priority based on my mental health, which I had neglected for so long. But that doesn't change the fact that Golden Boy built Canelo Alvarez, period. The company you fought under for decades has always had one name, and it's mine. So put some fucking respect on it. As for Jaime, he has always dared to be great, just as he's this Saturday night. And this serves as a bit of a full circle for him. Remember when Jaime was 21 years old, volunteered to step in against Triple G, and Canelo failed two drug tests? Though Jaime wasn't allowed to fulfill his dream, 2018, on Saturday night, he will do just that. Fulfill his dream and be world champion.
Tienen que escribirle lo que tiene que decir este pinche maricón, cabrón. Tú lo escribes. ¿Qué lo escribes, pendejo? Tú no escribes nada, cabrón. Tú no haces nada. O sea, tú no haces nada.
Yo lo escribí.
Eres un pendejo, eso es lo que eres.
Eres un baboso.
Eres un pendejo, cabrón, porque están nomás ahí. Los que hacen todo son los que están detrás de ti. Tú eres un pendejo nomás con la imagen, idiota.
Sí, sí, sí.
Cabrón.
Siéntate, güey.
All right, let's have everyone take a beat a little bit, and we will move on with our show. So
First, now we want to turn our attention to a man that's recently joined Jaime Munguia. He has helped him in his last fight, and now he looks to help Jaime Munguia accomplish his lifelong dream to become an undisputed world champion, defeating Canelo Alvarez. Let's please welcome the man who has been involved in so many legendary fights. He has trained so many legendary fighters. Please welcome Freddie Roach.
Hello, yes, my fighter Jaime, he's doing really well. We had a great training camp for this fight. He's really at the top of the game right now, and we're ready for this fight. Canelo's a very tough opponent, and we know that, but we're ready for whatever he brings to the table, and he's going to be the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Freddie. And now we will head on over to the other side, who will be going and trying to match wits with Freddie Roach. It should be a battle between two incredible trainers. First, I want to acknowledge Jose Chepo Reynoso, who is a huge part of the Canelo team and playing a role into it. So he will say a few words.
¿Qué tal? Buenas tardes a todos ustedes, todos y todas ustedes. Contento de estar esta tarde porque hace 20 años, en este mes de abril, llegó al gimnasio Julián Magdaleno, un muchachito de escasos 14 años.
So I'm really happy to be here with you all. Good afternoon, everybody. And, you know, I'm glad to be here because 20 years ago, at just 14 years old, a young man called Julián Magdaleno came to my gym.
Mi hijo Eddie y yo lo recibimos porque su hermano Rigoberto lo llevó, nos había platicado maravillas de él, y bueno, llegó al gimnasio ese mes de abril.
So, my son Eddie and I, we welcome him because, you know, Rigoberto had, you know, suggested that he could be someone that we wanted to meet, so we welcome him with open arms.
Y ver todo lo que ha provocado a lo largo de su carrera, pues, me llega la nostalgia, pero le doy gracias a Dios por todo lo que ha sucedido. Y les digo, si hay alguien que conozca a Saúl perfectamente, somos mi hijo Eddie y yo.
I can't help but be nostalgic a little bit that, you know, like going by the 20 years that have already passed and thinking about everything that we've gone through together. And I can tell you something, that nobody knows Saúl better than my son Eddie and I. We're really proud of him.
Sabemos lo que se ha batallado, lo que batalló, y sabemos el trabajo que costó llegar hasta donde estamos ahorita, donde está ahorita, y es trabajar, trabajar y trabajar. Son muchos años de trabajo, pero lo que lo tienen a donde está ahorita. Y donde está ahorita es una gran oportunidad de seguir demostrándole al mundo la clase de boxeador que es él. Y aparte, el rival que tiene, un gran rival, merece la oportunidad. Y son dos guerreros mexicanos que se van a enfrentar donde es la meca del boxeo mundial, como es aquí en Las Vegas.
Have there been challenges along the way? Sure. But in the end, we surpassed everything that we had to face because we worked, we worked, we worked. And now Saúl here has an opportunity to continue writing his story, to continue crafting his legacy. And he has a great opponent in front of him that also deserves the opportunity to go after his own glory. It's going to be a battle between two Mexican fighters, two Mexican warriors, and it's going to be something that you don't want to miss.
Seguramente el mundo va a ser testigo de una gran guerra entre dos mexicanos. Por eso, que viva México y que viva el boxeo mexicano. Muchas gracias.
It's a sure thing that the world is going to witness a war between two Mexican fighters. So, viva México.
And now let's bring up his son, who has helped guide Canelo to being the best fighter in boxing, pound for pound, manager and trainer Eddie Reynoso.
¿Qué tal? Buenas tardes. Muy agradecidos con todos los que están aquí, con todos los que hicieron también posible esta pelea, el equipo de Jaime Munguía, Fernando Beltrán, Dazón, PBC, Pues que no queda nada más que decir que estamos listos, hicimos una gran preparación. Sabemos que Jaime es un gran peleador, que tiene un gran equipo, por eso nos preparamos a conciencia y nada más esperar que el sábado digan viva México, porque aquí lo que va a ganar es el boxeo mexicano. Muchas gracias, mucho éxito para nosotros, éxito para Munguía, que baje bien del ring, que baje bien del ring de Saúl, y que sea una gran fiesta del boxeo mexicano, porque va a quedar en la historia del boxeo mexicano esta pelea. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much, Ray, for being here. And this is going to be a great fight between two outstanding Mexican fighters. I want to thank Team Munguía. I want to thank The Zone, PBC, and everybody that made this fight possible. And in the end, what's the most important thing is that you're going to see a war between two Mexican fighters that hopefully they both come out of the ring like healthy and well. And in the end, the real winner is going to be Mexico. And that we want, for the end of the fight, for everybody to be able to say, Viva Mexico.
All right, and now it is time to hear from our main event fighters. First, with the record 43 victories, 34 by knockout, he's the former 154-pound world champion from Tijuana, Baja California, Mexico, Jaime Munguía.
Bueno, ¿qué tal? Buenas tardes a todos. Muchas gracias por estar aquí. Gracias por a todos los que hicieron posible esta pelea. La verdad, me siento emocionado, me siento muy feliz de que pues ya estemos cerca de la hora de la hora. La verdad, creo que tuvimos una gran preparación. Quiero agradecer también a todo mi equipo por todo su apoyo durante todo el campamento. La verdad que, lo vuelvo a repetir, me siento feliz, me siento emocionado. Ya quiero que llegue el día y pues esperen todos una gran guerra mexicana y pues viva México. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much, everybody, for being here. I'm so happy, so excited. It's almost fight day. I want to thank my team for being behind me the whole way, and you can expect a full-out Mexican war. So tune in. You're not going to be disappointed, and I'm looking forward to what's going to be a great fight on Saturday night.
And now it is time to meet the face of boxing, the four-division world champion. He recently dominated the undisputed 154-pound champion, Jermell Charlo, back in September. He is the undisputed super middleweight world champion, the WBC, WBA, IBF, and WBO super middleweight world champion, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Muchas gracias. Muchas gracias, gracias a todos por estar aquí, como siempre, bien preparado, con mucho entusiasmo, contento de poder presentar esta pelea ante dos mexicanos, la primera vez en la historia, peleando los cuatro títulos, contento por eso, que estamos a unos días, obviamente él viene a ganar, yo vengo a ganar, eso quiere decir que va a ser una gran pelea, ¿no? Nos respetamos abajo del cuadrilátero, pero no quiere decir que vengamos a jugar matatena, ¿no? Venimos a pelear, venimos a darlo todo. Sábado vamos a ganar contundentemente y a eso venimos. Que todo el mundo disfrute y que sea una fiesta mexicana. Y para este imbécil intento de gente que tengo aquí a mi izquierda, que no se le olvide que yo ya vine siendo el Canelo a Estados Unidos y que solamente lucró con mi nombre. Nunca perdí un solo centavo, sino nomás ganó dinero. ¿Ya le pagaste a Golovkin lo que le quería robar? Sí, muy bien, porque también. Pero si no hubiera metido a mis abogados, me lo robas. Es lo único que hace este hombre es ser una lacra del boxeo, robarle a los boxeadores. Para el que esté con él, meta por favor ahí a sus abogados, porque seguramente les está robando. Es lo único que viene a hacer al boxeo.
You know who your daddy is.
Y a lo único que viene es a robarle la atención a Jaime Munguía. No viene a promoverlo. También le roba la atención a la gente que hace las cosas para la cocina. Ya no saben si hacerlas como consoladores o como cazuelas o algo. Porque acá se las mete el muchacho. Gracias a todos. Nos vemos el sábado.
All right, now we got a few questions for both of our fighters as we are getting set. First, we'll get a translation from Martin Batar.
All right, so as far as the fight, it's going to be a great Mexican war, and like Munguia and I, we both come to win. But I can guarantee you that I'm gonna win, I'm gonna prevail, and it's gonna be decisive. So you guys are gonna see a great fight. I want the fans to really enjoy Saturday night, and I'm proud to be here and to make history with both Mexican fighters fighting for the four belts for the first time. And then as far as what De La Hoya said, that, well, you know, like Canelo has his grudges against De La Hoya, and you know, where like he doesn't believe that what De La Hoya said was warranted, and you know, where he thinks that, you know, with the Golovkin fight, that there were some things that Mr. De La Hoya said or did that
he tried to steal money, and he's a fucking asshole. That's what I said. He's a fucking asshole. He tried to keep the attention for him, not for Munguia. He's a fucking asshole. He steals his fighters. That's what he do.
Focus on your fight.
Okay, and so that's pretty much it. Go ahead, Miguel.
Fucking pussy. Motherfucker.
All right.
I'm here for you too, motherfucker.
Focus on your fight.
All right, let's turn our attention back to Canelo and Munguia.
Wall Street Memes Casino.
I'm fine.
And sportsbook.